Good morning. How's everybody doing this morning? I hope you guys are having a great morning. And it is Wednesday. I had to think about that for a second. It's Wednesday morning and middle of the week, kind of hump day. It is hump day. So glad you guys are tuning in today. Hope everything's going well. I hope you had a good evening and ready for what God has for you today. Patsy, good to have you on here. Good to see you popping on. Anyway, good to see you guys, D. Good to have you on here. Hope you guys are doing great. Mom, Dad, good to see y'all. Scotty, I hope you and Phyllis are feeling well today and hanging in there. Miss seeing you guys, hanging out with you. Ray and Claude, hope you're doing well today. Here we are in the middle of the week. We're going to be back on Psalm 145. So again, turn to Psalm 145. We're going to kind of wrap this one up today, and then we'll continue on tomorrow morning, okay, with something different. So Rebecca, good to see you. Haven't seen you in a long time. This quarantine thing is crazy. So good to have you on here. Hope you're doing well. Thankful for you. Miss Sue, good to have you on here. And miss seeing you also. And anyway, thanks for getting on here. And anyway, all right. So again, Psalm 145. We're going to be looking at the last half of that. We're going to read quite a few verses, 10 through 21, and kind of walk through it a little bit. So here we go. Here's the joke. I'm going to give you the joke, and it's a good one today. So Pat Rodriguez, all the way from Pennsylvania and Philadelphia, she sent me this, and so thanks, Pat, for sending this to me. And here's the joke. You ready? It's this. Why didn't they play cards on the ark? Why didn't they play cards on the ark? That's a good question, because that's a long voyage. You'd think they'd have to have something to do. Why didn't they play cards on the ark? Well, here's the answer. Because Noah kept standing on the deck. Ah, there you go. That's a good church joke. Noah kept standing on the deck. All right. And you definitely can share that one. That's churchy. So just remember that. Anyway, good morning, Rick. Good to have you on here, man. I hope you're doing good. All right. Psalm 145, once again. Here we go. We're going to finish it up and to talk through verses 10 through 21. Just kind of read through it. And listen, these verses speak for themselves, really, as we continue on with David's praise of God and how all people should praise God because of who he is. And these verses that we begin to look at and think through, these last verses really are really digging in deep into who God is and what he does for us. And that's worthy of praise. He's always worthy of that praise. So David is really kind of digging in with this. Miss Carol, good morning to you. Glad you're on here. Miss Betty, good morning. Thanks for watching this morning. So here we go. Psalm 145, let's read that. All your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and all your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and tell of your power, to make known to the children of man your mighty deeds and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. The Lord is faithful in all his words and kind in all his works. Let's stop there for a second, because I know it's a big chunk of scripture, but let's stop there and just kind of think again of why David is writing this. And again, all your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and all your saints shall bless you. That's his goal. He wants to give God thanks and glory and honor. He wants to give God praise. He wants to give him what is due to him. And so not only him, but he's saying all believers, all saints, all those that follow after God should be able to bless him and should be blessing God and giving him praise. He said they shall speak of the glory, his glory, and tell of his power. You know, David was it was important to him for all people to know of God's glory and power. And he wanted to proclaim that to everybody. Listen, that's not necessarily something common today, talking about God's glory. We talk about God, and many times it's almost in a distant sense in our world today, but we really should be talking about his power and his glory and his honor, because he deserves that. And so David wanted all people to know that all people should be talking and speaking of God's glory. because he is magnificent and he is majestic and he is all these things. So that was a big thing for him. He says, your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures throughout all generations. His kingdom never ends. It never goes away. His kingdom will last forever. And what a great idea for us today, and news for us, good news for us today, that as all the things that are around us fade away, we recognize the truth that God's kingdom endures forever. So here's a thought about that. If in all the things that we experience and have today that are temporary, if the one thing that endures forever is God's kingdom, don't you think that is where we should be investing our time? Isn't that where we should be building on? And I think so. Many times we get so sidetracked on the temporary when really there's something that is eternal that we could be helping build forever. And so that also comes back to this, is are you sharing that truth with your neighbors and with your coworkers? They need to know that there is something eternal. God's kingdom is eternal. They could be a part of God's kingdom. And so and be encouraged in that, be challenged by that. May we spread his glory and talk about and speak of his kingdom. Okay, so let's go back down, starting in verse 14. And I love this part of the passage, and was just looking forward to speaking this and reading this, because it really talks about who God is and what he does and how he works in our life. And this is encouraging to me. Again, these are all reasons why David says we need to praise God. And it's so real for us today, just as it was for David at his time. So let's start in verse 14. The Lord upholds all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand, you satisfy the desires of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and kind in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He also hears their cry and saves them. The Lord preserves all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth will speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. First, let me just point this out. As we're reading that, I'm pretty sure it was very evident and clear of certain words that kind of popped out of these verses that really describe who God is and his action in our life. But before we do that, I think it's important to really kind of nail down something here. David, over and over and over again, about 11 times, I believe, in this passage, he uses the word all. Did you notice that? He says, the Lord upholds all and raises up all. I love that. David did this on purpose. Listen, this is an important word, all. Why? Because God's not just, we put God in a box sometimes, but listen, he can do this for all people, all those that give their life to him and follow after him. Listen, he is that big of a God that he wants to rescue all people. He wants to save all people. He does. That's his desire. He is not a puny God. He is a big God and strong God that is wanting to work in all people's lives. And that gives us a greater and more grander picture of our God. And that's what David is doing. Our God that is worthy of our praise and glory that we give him is a big God who wants to rescue all people. So let's look at some of these words that describe God. And I've underlined some of these, and maybe you can do that in your Bible too. And I'm looking at the ESV version. And listen, it says, the Lord upholds all who are falling. I love that. Upholds all. We're all going to slip. We're all going to make mistakes. He upholds those who are falling. Raises up all who are bowed down. When we are at our lowest, he picks us up. He raises us up. And that's his power. The eyes of all look to you, and you give. You give. God gives them food for their due season. He opens his hand. I love this picture, an open hand that God has for his children. You open your hand, you satisfy. God satisfies us in the desire of every living thing. And then it goes on, it says, the Lord is righteous in all his ways and kind in all his works. The Lord is near to all. He's very present in our life today. He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He also hears their cry. Listen, he fulfills, he satisfies, he hears, and then the Lord preserves all who love him. What an incredible painting that this makes of who God is. This really is a painting that comes together with all these words of our perfect and mighty God, the one that's near and fulfills and satisfies and hears and preserves. All these truths about our God come together to show us who this God is that we serve. And I love that about David. He is giving us an incredible detailed understanding and picture of this God that he says we all need to praise and give glory to, which is so true. And all these things are real in your life as well. Not just David, not just in biblical times, but now, as we're a part of God's story now, this truth of who God is valid and real for us today, even more today, and because God doesn't change. He preserves us. He lifts us up. He is present. He fulfills. He satisfies. He hears. Our God does all these things and so much more. And so understanding that, I pray that gives us encouragement today, but it also gives us the motivation to proclaim his greatness and glory to this world. Your neighbors may need to hear this today. Your coworkers may need to hear today that there is someone who is near, someone that can lift them up, that can help them to preserve their life, someone that can that hears their cries. Your coworker, your neighbor needs to hear that today, and so encourage them in that. Now I'm going to end with verse 21. And this is, as many will say, this is David's last word in the Bible. This is it. This is like his farewell. It says, "My mouth will speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever." That's a pretty good way to close it out for him. He wants all people to bless his name, to bless the name of the Lord forever and ever. So may we follow suit. May we do that with our life, because God is worthy. All right. Thanks, guys, for hanging out today. And I hope you have a great morning. Share this with others so that others can hear God's word today. And maybe it'll pop up in the middle of their work day. And it's something they can listen to. So thank you guys for tuning in. Let me pray for you. And then we'll move on. Let's pray. God, thank you for today. I lift up everyone that's watching and those that will be watching. And I pray that you give us just the strength to proclaim your name boldly, that we would walk in courage and clarity, and we would proclaim your name to all people, because you're worthy and you truly change lives. So may we be willing to share this life-saving truth of who you are with all people. Give us that, God. Give us that strength. And we pray for life change in ourselves and others, and pray that you get all the honor and glory. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks, y'all, for tuning in. We will be back in the morning at 10 o'clock. So set your clock. Make sure you're here. And it's good to have everybody on this morning. And listen, no matter where you find yourself today, know that God has put you there for a purpose. So shine bright for him and be his missionary. God bless you guys. And we will see you soon.